Good morning. Welcome back, Fairlawn family. We are so glad that you have joined us again for another morning online together. If you are new with us this morning and not part of our original Fairlawn family, then welcome. We're so glad that you're here with us. Let us know that you're here, Fairlawn family. Comment your names below and hey, chit-chat and say hi to each other. This is your time to catch up and, you know, let each other know that you're thinking about each other, right? And if you are new and it's your first time with us and you would like to connect with us, comment connect in the comments below. And Rachel is online and she will be happy to send you out some information about Fairlawn and let you know a little bit more about our church. Well, we have a special service planned for you this morning, and we're going to get into that in just a little while. But before we get started, I think we should pray and ask God's blessing on our morning. So let's go to Him. God, I thank you so much for our morning. And Lord, I pray that you would just come and be with us now. And even though we're here and there and everywhere this morning, we are connected because we are a part of your family. And so we're so grateful for that, that even in a time when we can't physically be together, we're together with you, and we're so grateful for that, Lord. And God, I pray that you would just bless our time this morning, bless this group as they're going to sing for us this morning. And we're so grateful that they're able to be here with us. And I thank you for this time again, in Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so, as you know, every time when we begin like this, especially online, we get to go right into kids' church. And so we're going to do that this morning. So kids, if you're ready, just grab an iPad or whatever and get online because we are going to go right into where we left off last week with Jacob. But maybe before we get into that, maybe I should go back and review just a little bit in case you forgot. So we're still in Genesis. We're still moving through the Bible. And we're finding out how God is blessing and getting ready to have this big nation through Abraham, Isaac, and now we're in Jacob, right? And do you remember that a little while ago, a couple weeks ago, Jacob went to his dad Isaac in disguise, and he tricked Isaac into giving him a blessing that wasn't originally for him. But actually it was, right? Because God had everything planned out already. And Jacob was going to get that blessing. He didn't have to trick Isaac into it. Jacob went ahead of God and wasn't trusting him. And it made a huge mess. It made a mess between him and his brother Esau, his twin brother. Because remember, then he had to run away and live somewhere else for a long time. And when he ran away and he was living with his relative Laban, he fell in love. Remember that last week? And he wanted to get married to a beautiful girl named Rachel. And just like he tricked his dad, do you remember? Rachel's dad, Laban, tricked him into marrying another sister, Leah, and then he ended up with two wives. It's craziness all the way around. Oh, my goodness. Anyway, so last week at the end, everything started to work out because he remembered, okay, God, you're still with me, and you are blessing me, and I thank you for that. And he ran off with Rachel and Leah and the big giant family that God was blessing him with, and he headed home towards his dad Isaac and his brother Esau. So now we're going to catch up with him as he's traveling home. Now, because he left after tricking his dad and making his brother really mad, for 20 years he has lived away from his brother Esau in fear that his brother hated him, and he was scared to death to ever go back and see his brother again. He didn't know what his brother was going to do because his brother was so angry when he left. So as he's getting closer and closer to his brother Esau, he just started getting more and more nervous about what was going to happen when he saw him. And Jacob had an enormous family that God blessed him with. He had 12 sons, all these children. He had tons of animals, sheep and goats and camels and cows and donkeys. The Bible tells us he had all kinds of stuff. And so he had this huge caravan that was traveling with him. And so he decided that maybe he better protect himself a little bit. So he sent his servants on ahead to let his brother know that he was coming. And with his servants, he sent a whole bunch of animals as gifts for Esau so that Esau would be happy when he saw him. He thought, oh, I'll just butter him up with all this stuff, and then maybe he'll forgive me, and everything will be okay when we finally see each other. Well, the servants came back to Jacob, and they said, we saw Esau, and by the way, he's coming with like 400 guys. Do you think Jacob was a little nervous at that point? Oh, he was so crazy nervous and afraid. Was he trusting God? Do you think that God had a plan? He was blessing Jacob all along. Do you really think that he was going to bring Jacob this far and then be like, oh, Esau's going to wipe you out, dude. Sorry. I don't think so. I don't think that's the way it was going to work. But Jacob was really, really scared. And so he split up his family into two groups so that if one group was captured by Esau, the other group could run off and be okay. How crazy is that? And he was just getting so nervous, and it got to be towards nighttime. And he took the groups that he had split up, and he crossed them across a creek. And he told them to stay there for a night where they would be a little bit safer. They were a little further away. And then he went back across the stream, and it was getting towards nighttime. And the Bible tells us that a man came to him and started wrestling with him. Have you ever wrestled with one of your siblings? It can be kind of fun, right? Well, Jacob and this guy wrestled all night long. And come to find out, this guy was actually God in the form of a man who came down and was wrestling with Jacob. And the guy was like, let me go, let me go. And Jacob was holding on to him. He was holding on to God. And he said, I'm not going to let you go until you bless me. Bless me. And God touched his hip and actually gave him an injury. And he ended up limping for a long time afterwards. But God said to him, Jacob, I do bless you. I am with you. And to show you that I'm blessing you and that I love you and I'm going to take care of you, I'm going to change your name. I'm going to give you a new name because you're going to be a new guy. Because I know, Jacob, that after this, you are going to completely trust me from here on out. And he said, so I'm going to change your name from Jacob, which actually means deceiver, which is pretty cool because the guy was like a tricky guy, right? He was always tricking people. So, I mean, who knew? But his name was Jacob, the deceiver. And God said, I'm going to change your name to Israel, which actually means one who wrestles with God. But Israel ended up being the name of the great big nation that came from his family. Isn't that so cool? God chose to change his name to prove to him and to show him that I am with you and I am going to bless you. I'm always going to be with you. You know, it makes me think of another time when a name change happens. You know, way down the line, past Jacob, past when the nation of Israel got bigger and bigger and bigger, a guy named Jesus came out of the nation of Israel, came from God. We know who Jesus is. He came as a savior to save us and to bless us. And did you know that when you accept Jesus into your life, when you tell Jesus that you love him and that you believe that he died for you and he rose again, your name changes too. You're not just Miss Jody anymore. You are, or whatever your name is, I become Miss Jody, child of God, because I'm part of God's family at that point. How cool is that? Jacob's name changed to Israel to remind him that God was with him and blessing him. My name changed when I accepted Jesus to child of God to remind me that God is always with me and he is going to bless me. And if that has never happened for you, boy, I sure wish that you would reach out to me because I would like to talk to you about accepting Jesus as your own Savior. Because it's an easy thing to do and God loves you so, so much. I would love to talk to you about it. So you go ahead and message me if you would like to talk about something like that. All right. Okay, that is the end of Kids Church today. Oh, and if you want to read the whole story, because there's more to it than what I could fit in that little spot, there's more to that story. You can go to the book of Genesis in your own Bible, chapter 32, 33, and 34, and you can read all the details, because there's lots of details to that story. All right, well, this morning, we have something really special for your whole family. We have a quartet. There's a Southern Gospel quartet called Redeemed here today. And one of the guys on the team, the quartet team, is actually from our church. He's the head of our Shepherd Staff Security Group. And they are going to come on up, guys. They're going to come on up, and they are going to share with us an entire concert this morning. So buckle in, because it's going to be fabulous. All right, guys. It's all you.
Well, hello, Fairlawn. It is great to be with you today. And, you know, when we scheduled these concerts, we never expected things to be like they are right now. Things sure have changed. But, you know, something that is exciting today, we know that our Lord and Savior, He never changes, and He's there for us. I look back through my life, and I see where He's always been there. He is so faithful.
Since the day when I surrendered, many years have come and gone. Joy and sadness I remember, Lord, You were faithful. Brought me across the desert dry. You were my friend when I was lonely. You whispered peace and made me smile as I surveyed joy and sorrow. I find Your love remains the same, so I will trust You for tomorrow, 'cause You were faithful. By Your mercy I'm still standing, and by Your grace I have been saved. In Your goodness I'm still trusting that You will brought me across the desert dry. You were my friend when I was lonely. You whispered peace and made me smile as I
Accepted Jesus as your Savior. Do you remember that day? Do you remember the excitement that you had? I ask you today, do you have that same excitement? You know, so often it's easy to get caught up in the things of this world. But all we need to do is stay focused on Him. We have a song here with a little different beat. But it's got a great, great message. It's called My, My, My.
Jesus, oh, that I could explain the way I feel. Rejoicing in unspeakable joy and full glory. It's amazing, but praise God, I know it's real.
When I received salvation, I felt such jubilation. When Jesus came and washed my sins away, He gives me strength and power to face the midnight hour. With all my heart and soul I now can say,
my, 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 what a joy to serve my Jesus. Oh, that I could explain the way I feel. Rejoicing in unspeakable joy and full glory. It's amazing, but praise God, I know it's real.
Now Jesus is my Savior, He gives me love and favor. He's my Redeemer, Master, Lord, and King. Down here I'll tell my story, I'll give God all the glory. He brought me out and gave me a song to sing.
My, 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 what a joy to serve my Jesus. Oh, that I could explain the way I feel. Rejoicing in unspeakable joy and full glory. It's amazing, but praise God, I know it's real. My, my, my,
what a joy to serve my Jesus.
Oh, that I could explain the way I feel. Rejoicing in unspeakable joy and full glory. It's amazing, but praise God, I know it's real. It's amazing, but praise God, I know it's real. It's amazing, but praise God, I know it's real.
Oh,
my, 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 what a joy to serve my Jesus. Oh, that I could explain the way I feel. Rejoicing in unspeakable joy and full glory. It's amazing, but praise God, I know it's real. It's amazing, but praise God, I know it's real. It's amazing, but praise God, I know it's real. It's real.
Amen. Amen. You know, this next song, it says, if we could praise him for a million years. And when we think about a million years, we think that's a long, 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 long time. But, you know, we're going to have the chance to praise him for eternity, which is nothing compared to a million years. He's so, so good to me. I just look forward to spending time on my knees just praising him. Amen?
Once I was lost in sin, I had no peace within. My heart was lonely and so sad. Till Jesus came along, gave me a happy song. He gave me joy and made me glad. And now my way is bright. He fills each day and night with blessings all along the way. I try to count them one by one. Still I could never thank him quite enough
for everything,
for all he's done for me.
And when I reach,
my home in heaven above, my Savior I will see
and
look upon his blessed face, thank him for saving grace. He has been so good to me. Sometimes I lose my way and Satan tries to say, your God has left you all alone. You know it's not worthwhile to walk another mile. There is no reason to go on. I look ahead and see my Lord is leading me, and soon we'll make it safely home. I know that heaven is just ahead. I will be safely led. Keep traveling on.
If I could praise him for
a million years,
thank him for
eternity.
Still I could never thank him
quite enough
for everything,
for all he's done for me.
And when I reach my home
in heaven above, my Savior I will see. Look upon his blessed face, thank him for saving grace. He has been so good to me.
If I could praise him for
a million years,
thank him for
and for eternity.
Still I could never
thank him quite enough
for everything,
for all he's done for me.
And when I reach my home
in heaven above, my Savior I will see
and
look upon his blessed face, thank him for saving grace. He has been so good to me.
Amen. Well, I want to take a real quick moment here, and I want to introduce the group to you. And guys, this is the only break you're going to get all day long, okay? So, suck up the air and get those lungs expanded and everything. So we'll start down here on the far end. If you can't tell already, he is our bass singer of the group. He does a great job. He comes from Community Baptist Church, right? Did I get that right? In Mentorsville. Right next to him here is our lead singer of the group. This is Gene Bixby. He comes all the way up in New Albany, PA, from the Evergreen Community Church. Did I get that right? Close? Close enough. Okay. And right here beside me is our tenor singer of the group. That's that real, real high voice. And he goes to Trinity Assembly of God Church. And my name is Jim Barrett. I'm the baritone part of the group. And I go to Fairlawn. Yay, Fairlawn. Okay. So that makes up the group. It is so, so great to be with you today. I want to just say a special thanks to the audio and video people that are just taking care of things here. I'll tell you what, the stuff that they do in the background is just amazing. So when we get back here, meeting together and stuff, well, you just make sure you let them know how much you appreciate them and what they've done for us. So, quartets, we love to feature our bass singers, at least one song, okay? And we think we have a pretty good bass singer. He's actually the best bass singer out of the four of us, okay? So we're going to continue to let him sing bass. So this is your song. It's your time to shine, okay? So make sure you get it really, really hit that low note really low for them, okay? All right. I cast my bread upon the water. A little practice here?
Yeah.
I cast my bread upon the water by helping my brother struggling on life's stormy sea. And I'll be sowing a good seed by doing a good deed that'll come back to me. Well, I picked up the good book and took me a long look. I believe in each and every part, but I sure rejoiced in knowing about the reaping and the sowing. I really took that lesson to my heart. I cast my bread upon the water by helping my brother struggling on life's stormy sea. Sowing a good seed by doing a good deed that'll come back to me.
You know, good deeds alone are not going to get you to heaven. It's only by the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ and accepting Him as your Lord and Savior. But I believe today if you know Him, you'll want to be doing good deeds.
Well, I can't find my way to heaven, but there's a heaven awaiting, purchased by our good and loving Lord.
And I'll go on striving, trusting and surviving, holding on, expecting my reward.
I cast my bread upon the water by helping my brother struggling on life's stormy sea. Sowing a good seed by doing a good deed that'll come back to me.
Yeah, I cast my
bread upon the water,
in the water,
by helping
my brother
struggling on life's stormy sea.
And I'll be
sowing a good seed,
a seed
by doing a good deed,
a deed
that'll come back to me. I cast my bread upon the water by helping my brother struggling on life's stormy sea. And I'll be sowing a good seed by doing a good deed that'll
come back
to me. I cast my bread upon the water by helping my brother struggling on life's stormy sea. And I'll be sowing a good seed by doing a good deed that'll
come
back to me. Yes, it's gonna come back to me.
You know, we are going to spend eternity sometime, either in heaven or hell. There's two places. But you know, this is not my home here. We can make our choice by accepting Him as your Lord and Savior and knowing that heaven is your final destination. Or you could ignore Him and know that hell is where you'll go. My friend, I'm here today to tell you that those two places are real. And it's my hope and my prayer that everybody that's listening today knows for sure that they will spend their eternity in heaven. Heaven is.
This old world is not where I belong. Heaven is. It was never meant to be my home. Heaven is. So I will not hold a treasure dear. I'm bound for a land where there are no tears. What is this place of joy so dear? Heaven is where the glorious Lamb of God forever reigns. Heaven is where I'll sing one day with the angels and the saints. Ask me what is waiting, cause the Savior made me his. Heaven is,
heaven is,
heaven is.
Oh, what is this place our Lord's prepared? Heaven is.
When he calls my name, I'll wake up where heaven is. There are golden streets and jasper walls, a paradise to my heart it calls. And I can't wait to see it all. Heaven is where the glorious Lamb of God forever reigns. Heaven is where I'll sing one day with the angels and the saints. Ask me what is waiting, cause the Savior made me his. Heaven is.
Heaven is.
Heaven is. Heaven is where we'll pick our crowns and lay them at his feet. Heaven is where we'll join the choir of the ransomed and redeemed. The joy of knowing Jesus and
be assured of this.
Heaven is.
Heaven is.
Heaven is. I know that heaven is where the glorious Lamb of God forever reigns. Heaven is where I'll sing one day with the angels and the saints. Oh, ask me what is waiting, cause the Savior made me in. Heaven is.
Heaven is.
Heaven is. Heaven is.
Heaven is.
Heaven is where we'll join the choir of the ransomed and redeemed. The joy of knowing Jesus and
be assured of this.
Heaven is.
Heaven is.
Heaven is. I know that heaven is where the glorious Lamb of God forever reigns. Heaven is where I'll sing one day with the angels and the saints. Oh, ask me what is waiting, cause the Savior made me in. Heaven is.
Heaven is.
Heaven is. Heaven is.
Heaven is.
Heaven is.
There's a land called
Canaan where the milk and honey's flowing. Canaan land is where I'm going. I've been laying up treasures for a long, long time. They say there's walls of jasper there, wonderful sights of beauty rare. I have made my plan, heaven's mine.
I'm looking ahead.
I am looking ahead.
Nothing behind.
There is nothing behind.
I've come
too
far.
I have come too far to turn around this time. I am plaiting my garments, putting on a robe that's spotless white. I'm bound for that city, heaven's mine.
glorious day when the Lord descends from heaven and returns to claim his children. I'll be ready and waiting when he arrives. I'm gonna keep on walking those paths straight till I reach the pearly gate. I have made my plan, heaven's mine. I'm looking ahead.
I am looking ahead.
There's nothing behind.
There is nothing behind.
I've come too far.
I have come too far to
turn around this time.
I am braiding my garment, putting on a robe that's spotless white. I'm bound for that city, heaven's mine.
I'm looking ahead.
I am looking ahead.
There's nothing behind.
There is nothing behind.
I've come too far.
I have come too far to turn around this time. I am braiding my garment, putting on a robe that's spotless white. I'm bound for that city, heaven's mine.
I'm looking ahead.
I am looking ahead.
There's nothing behind.
There is nothing behind.
I've come too far.
I have come too far to turn around this time. I am braiding my garment, putting on a robe that's spotless white. I'm bound for that city, heaven's mine. I'm bound for that city, heaven's mine.
Puts you up there a little bit, doesn't it, buddy? Oh, yeah. This next song we're going to do is called Something. And boy, let me tell you what, was it ever something to learn? There's so many words that just go just so fast in this song. And the chorus says, nothing, not nothing, because nothing becomes something. He makes something out of nothing because he believes that nobody is nobody, because somebody takes nobody's and makes somebody's out of nobody's like me. That make any sense to you? Well, let me tell you why. It doesn't when you read it, but when you put the music to it, it really makes sense. Because anything that God makes, he puts us together. Amen? Something. If they get that now, nothing is nothing.
Maybe you feel worthless, totally insignificant, a little speck in a big, big world. You think you're not important, you're unnoticeable, that's not remotely possible with God.
Here we go now.
Nothing's not nothing, cause nothing becomes something. He makes something out of nothing, cause he believes. And nobody is nobody, cause somebody makes nobody great. Somebody's out of nobody's like me. Gathered with the hungry, the disciples told the Lord, there's no food for the people today.
A little boy came forward with a little piece and bread, and the Lord turned nothing meal into something great.
Nothing's not nothing, cause nothing becomes something. He makes something out of nothing, cause we believe that nobody is nobody, cause somebody makes nobody makes. Somebody's out of nobody like me. Nothing with God. Nothing becomes something with God.
Nobody
or somebody with God. Nobody or somebody with God. Nothing's not nothing, cause nothing becomes something. He makes something out of nothing, cause he believes that nobody is nobody, cause somebody makes nobody's makes. Somebody's out of nobody like me.
Somebody
like you.
Somebody
and me.
Like
somebody.
somebody like you and me.
Somebody like you and me.
Did you ever take time to just sit and think of why God would send his son here on earth? You know, he loved us that much. He knew that there was nothing that we could do, that he had to do it all. That's why he sent his son. Gene, come and sing for us.
Knew we'd be so lost without him. That's why he left heaven's throne to come as a child to the wicked and wild, not to condemn but atone. He knew that we needed forgiveness. That's why his mercy was free. All hope was lost, he became the cost to ransom a sinner like me. Now I am living in the promise. There is grace for every need. He knew that we needed a Savior. That's why his precious blood flows.
And I do believe every drop was for me, and that's why I love him so.
Ooh, he knew that we all needed healing. That's why he took every stripe, the hammer and nails, the anguish he felt was torment that should have been mine. But he could see hope in the making for someone as hopeless as me. That's why he arose over death he imposed, so that I could forever go free.
And I am living in the promise. There is grace for every need.
He knew that we needed a Savior. That's why his precious blood flows.
I do believe every drop was for me, and that's why I love him so.
Yes,
I do believe every drop was for me, and that's why I love him so.
That is why
I love him so.
I love him so.
That is why
I love him so.
Next song is called I'll Live Again. And you know, I don't want to leave my family here, but I know one day when I pass away, that I'll be in heaven and I'll live with him. And I am also looking forward to that day. I hope each and every one out there today can also say that, that they know that they'll expend eternity in heaven. I'll live again.
If some morning I am gone from this vale of tears,
I'm going home
to live again. I am going on a trip when they say goodbye.
I'll live again
over on the other side.
I'll live again over on that golden strand. I'll sing and shout
with a mighty angel band.
And you'll see me rise beyond the starry skies.
I'll live again over on the other side. I've a mansion over there, built in beauty rare.
I'm going home
to live again.
And when they lay me in the grave,
don't you weep for me.
I'll live again
over on the other side.
I'll live again over on that golden strand. I'll sing and shout
with a mighty angel band.
And you'll see me rise beyond the starry skies.
I'll live again
over on the other side.
And I'll live again over on that golden strand. I'll sing and shout
with a mighty angel band.
You'll see me rise beyond the starry skies.
I'll live again
over on the other side.
Yes, I'll live again over on that golden strand. I'll sing and shout
with a mighty angel band.
And you'll see me rise beyond the starry skies.
I'll live again
over on the other side.
I'll live again
over on the other side.
You know, we serve an amazing God. As I said in the beginning of a concert here, you know, you look through your life, and if you've served him, it doesn't take long at all to see how special he is and how he loves his people and what he does for us. Monty, I want you to come and sing now a song called Amazing God.
Want to hear the story of how I made it through? When life is full of trouble, pain and fear, the answer may sound simple, though everything else crumbles. But one thing has remained through all the I still serve
an amazing God. He's been with me every mile my weary feet have trod. He still cares. He still hears. He's still mending broken hearts and drying.
God who parted waters still makes a way today. He's always brought me through the troubled seas. The one who fed the thousands, whose words could calm the tempest. He's my bread of life, and he's my peace. I still serve
an amazing God. He's been with me every mile my weary feet have trod. He still
still serve an amazing God. He's been with me every mile my weary feet have trod.
He still cares. He still hears. He's still mending broken hearts
and drying tears.
This old world is bound to change, but I'm glad I know the one who always stays the same, and my song will ever be. Amazing God, you're still amazing.
We have a couple more songs I want to do for you today, but before we do, I just want to quickly tell you, normally when we're at a service, we do have tapes and CDs and things like that out there, but you can't get them today. So, but if you're really interested, it's pretty easy to get to them. You can go to our website at just Google Redeemed of PA, and you'll find it, and you can... There's contact information in there, and you can get a CD or a tape from us. Boy, kids, they don't even remember what tapes are anymore, huh? We're just about out of tapes. So, and also, if you're watching from another church and you'd like to have the group, just, like I said, Google that, Redeemed of PA, and you will find contact information. You can get with one of us, and we can maybe come to your church sometime. So we're now going to have Gene do a song called God is Great. I almost need my cowboy hat and horse for this one.
Looking back over my life, God's good, so good. It's a fact. Sometimes I took the wrong track, but God's good, so good. When I look where I've been and what He brought me through, all I can say is God's been so good. But on second thought,
God's been great.
How great is God's amazing.
amazing grace, the grace that sought me. Great the blood that bought me, how great.
How long
are his arms of mercy?
Reached way down to the bottom, picked me up. No problem, ain't God good.
No, God's great.
Moving on, I've got a new song, 'cause God's good, so good. When I'm faced with trials in my way, God's good, so good. When I'm questioned about this smile on my face, I must reply, all I can say is God been so good. But on second thought,
God's been great. How great,
how great
is God's amazing grace. Amazing grace, the grace that sought me. Great the blood that bought me, how great.
How long
are his arms of mercy?
Reached way down to the bottom, picked me up. No problem, ain't God good.
No, God's great. Amazing grace, the grace that sought me. Great the blood that bought me, how great.
How long
are his arms of mercy?
Reached way down to the bottom, picked me up. No problem, ain't God good.
No, God's great.
Reached way down to the bottom, pick me up. No problem, ain't God good.
No, God's great.
We have one last song we want to do for you, and it's called He Still Speaks. And I hope everybody out there today knows that our Lord and Savior does speak to us. I got to tell you real quickly, I'm going to try not to preach here. I think, I won't preach, but I think I heard somebody one day say that if you can't say it in 20 minutes, it can't be said. Well, I don't have 20 minutes. I have about 2 minutes. So, there was a show that, this is probably a year or so or more ago now, that our vice president of the United States was on. And he's a Christian man. And he was talking about speaking to the Lord. And then he spoke about the Lord speaking to him. And the people on this show, they kind of mocked him and laughed at him and said, it's one thing to say you're speaking to God, but to say that he's speaking to you and you hear him, they just didn't get that. They didn't understand. And as Christians, there's many times in our life, as I said earlier, we get caught up in things of this world. And we get so busy, and we miss hearing from our Lord and Savior. But he does speak to us. Things have been so different for the last few months. And I think the most of us have had so much more time on our hands than we've ever had. I've enjoyed just seeing the family unit coming together, hearing things on Facebook and YouTube and stuff about people saying, we sat down as a family and had supper tonight. we get away from that. We get caught up in things of this world. So, you know, there's no better time than now when we have a lot of time on our hands. That we can get on our knees, we can get on our Bibles, and we get focused on Him. Because He's there. He hasn't gone anyplace. He has not changed. And if we stay in tune with Him, we will hear what He has for us. Amen? He still speaks.
Amidst the hustling, clamoring world, sometimes it's hard to hear the voice of God speaking to my soul. But in my quiet time alone, when I approach His holy throne, His tender words fall gently on my ears.
He still speaks. I know.
So many who still doubt that God can speak today. They laugh and mock when we say we've heard from God. Yet the still small voice of God is heard above the doubters of this world. His timeless words ring out with hope today.
He still I know His voice, sweeter sound never heard by mortal ears. And to think that God, by His own choice, would speak to me, it makes me rejoice. He still
something that was said today was a blessing to each and every one of you. I'm going to ask Gene here to just close this portion of our singing with a prayer. And as Jody said earlier, you know, if you don't know Him as your Lord and Savior, and you want to know more, please contact the church. Contact one of us. I told you about our website earlier. Get with us. We'd love to sit down and we'd love to talk with you. We hope you enjoyed our service. Gene, please close in prayer.
Father in heaven, how wonderful it is to be able to come and to sing praises to your name. Lord, we thank you for this opportunity that we had today. And Lord, we know it's a troubled time in our world. And Lord, we know there's many difficulties out there. But Lord, we know that you have told us that all things work together for good for those that love you. And so, Lord, just help each one of us to put our trust in you to carry us through the hard times. In your name we pray. Amen.
Thank you so much for joining us this morning for a super special service with the Redeemed Group. They were amazing, weren't they? They had such great harmony, and I just had so much fun listening to them, and we're so glad that you joined us for that. Thank you. Next week, you can join us up here again, but in person. It's a drive-in service next week, so help us pack the parking lot next week. It's our last drive-in service before we get to open the building up again, and we are so excited about that. But before we open up the building, we do want to pack the parking lot because we do love drive-in service, so help us do that next week. All right, in the meantime, Miss Rachel is going to put a link in the comments for giving, and we just are so grateful for your generous giving through this entire time. So use that link if you would like to. And one more thing before I let you go today. On Saturday nights, we have a prayer meeting together online, and we would love for you to join us for that. If you would like to connect with us on prayer meeting and pray with us for things here and around the world, there is always a link in the Flock Note bulletin each week. But if you need the link and you don't get the bulletin, just comment prayer in the comments today and Rachel will hook you up with that. All right? Hey, you guys have a great Sunday today, and we will see you next week outside for drive-in service. Have a good day.